Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. In this video today, we're going to be talking about a couple of different subjects, including a brand new exclusive $100 camouflage pattern. You heard that correctly. There is an exclusive $100 camouflage pattern in the form of Golden Cheetah, and there's only one way to earn this thing, and that is by purchasing $100 worth of items through the Call of Duty shop. This is not the first time that we've seen them do an exclusive camouflage pattern through the Call of Duty shop. Last time they did an exclusive camo, it was Royalty Tiger. This is what it looks like. And in order to have gotten this camouflage pattern, you needed to buy the TF-141 shoulder sling bag. That came alongside it as a bonus item. The Golden Cheetah camo isn't exclusive to any one specific item. It just asks that you buy $100 worth of items in the shop in order to be emailed this code. And this is what the camo looks like. It's not bad. It's just something that we had back in Call of Duty World War II. If you remember, they added Golden Cheetah and Golden Leopard as bonus camos that you can earn by completing additional camouflage challenges. It's pretty much the same thing. Just like Royalty Tiger was one of the camo patterns from Call of Duty World War II. They seem to be adding a lot of those camos back, but I'm a little bit split on how to feel about the $100 camo, and it's mainly because the camo pattern really isn't the reason you're gonna get stuff from the COD shop. And the stuff that you're getting, thankfully, is physical, tangible items, whether it's clothing that you're going to wear, or a backpack you're going to use, or cups, or phone cases, or whatever. You know, adding $100 worth of items or collectibles through the COD shop is not really a difficult thing to do, especially if you're going to be buying multiple items. So in this case, having this as an additional bonus to have in-game, I honestly think it's pretty cool, especially if you are already going to get items from the COD shop, like a t-shirt or whatever. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. This is definitely an interesting way to see them spark up some more sales for the Call of Duty shop. It would have been cool if it was like an animated camouflage pattern, if it was a little flashier. It's kind of dull. It's pretty much how I remember it from World War II. It's just, you know, they've upgraded the graphical fidelity of it at this point. So yeah, there's another exclusive camo that you can get, but only if you spend $100 on physical items. Leave your thoughts about that in the comments section below. Today marks the beginning of a brand new event called Blaze Up. There are multiple challenges to complete, whether it's in multiplayer, zombies, or Warzone. You have a chance to get a handful of items, including calling cards, double XP tokens, stickers, emblems, and you can even get a killstreak skin called the Weedson for the Wheelson. I do like this event mainly because it actually forces you to play a little bit different than you normally would, specifically when it comes to multiplayer. All of the other challenges for zombies and for Warzone are pretty straightforward, but when it comes to multiplayer, they're quite unique in what they're asking you to do. So for example, there's one that asks you to actually throw tear gas while you have the TAC mask perk equipped. There's another one that asks you to get JAK purifier kills while concealed in smoke, which is just, I mean, admittedly, it's pretty on the nose for, you know, the event itself. At the very end, you'll get a mastery reward after completing all of the challenges called Daymares, and this is what it looks like. It says, be free, smoke weed on the grip, and the blueprint is animated, so you can see that there is a strain that's going across it. Overall, really cool. The Sloth was added today as well, which is a Captain Price skin, something I did not expect to see. But on top of that, we also have some daily login rewards that are going to be taking place. These include emblem, large decal, sticker, double battle pass XP, and finally on day 5 you get a calling card. All of these can just be claimed for, of course, logging in. Now these are only going to be available for 10 days, so you got to log in at least 5 times out of those 10 days to get all of these rewards, and the Blaze Up event is going to be taking place for a total of 13 days, so there's plenty of time to go through and do the challenges. Admittedly, some of these challenges are much easier to do in Warzone, some of them are much easier to do in zombies. It all comes down to what you're feeling and how quickly you want to complete these challenges. Our weekly challenges this time around also gave us access to the JAK Jawbreaker, which is an aftermarket part for the KV Broadside, a Modern Warfare 2 shotgun, by the way. This actually converts it into a battle rifle that does pack a pretty powerful punch, especially when we're talking core game modes. And on top of that, it's incredibly stable. The downside is you can't add on any extra magazine attachments, so you're stuck at 20 rounds, which means you're going to be reloading pretty often. You can utilize other attachments that you normally wouldn't be able to use on the KV Broadside, like the Shadow Strike Suppressor. It's really cool. Once you attach it, it does turn it into like a completely different feeling weapon. I have been saying, and I will continue to say, the aftermarket parts that Sledgehammer added to Modern Warfare 3 has to be the most brilliant idea we've seen in quite some time. Not only does it get players coming back for more every single week, but it's like getting a brand new weapon depending on what the aftermarket part is. If it comes down to just being a, you know, like a grip or a sight like we've seen in the past, it's not as enjoyable, but at the same time, it's still something new and unique that you can use on some of your favorite loadouts all throughout the game. This is definitely one of those things that I would like to see moving forward in future Call of Duty games. It's always these cool features that end up getting taken away in future games. I don't understand why they do that. And speaking of future games, there was a pretty substantial leak that may be affecting the upcoming Call of Duty Gulf War, and I want to talk a little bit about it because it has to do with shields, Riot shields in specific. Allegedly found within the game code, there was a shield field upgrade found. Instead of having a full-fledged Riot Shield that you can equip from the Create a Class menu, there is now going to be a shield that you get as a field upgrade. And the interesting part about this shield is it can apparently be destroyed. So it's not going to be something that you get infinitely after you use your field upgrade. It's something that you can use temporarily to maybe hold down a specific objective until it's destroyed. Something that you can utilize to maybe run up and bash enemies or protect an objective. Like if you're playing Search and Destroy and you need that additional second or two to try to distract enemies, this is your chance to do that. And I think that that's a really, really cool idea. Something that could really combat the players that just love to run Riot Shields on their back with overkill all the time. You know, I'm not going to sit here and complain about it too much because admittedly, I'm also part of the problem. I kind of did that before when it came to a couple of the overkill challenges that I had to do in the past. It's not something that I like to do all the time, but like, especially when you're working on, you know, melee weapons, having that additional protection on your back while you're running around and knifing, that is nice to an extent. And here's the thing. I think that if it comes in the form of a field upgrade and they decide to do a fast recharge on it, it's still going to be a beneficial thing to have for at least a few seconds to give you some additional protection on your back if you are going knifing only, or if you are trying to capture an objective, or if you are trying to do anything that does require a shield. It's not going to give you unlimited protection like a lot of the stuff does now in our modern Call of Duty games. And I think that that's one of the most frustrating points for players, not only in Warzone, but also for standard multiplayer. But yeah, that's pretty much it. I'd like to know what y'all think about it in the comment section below. If you guys enjoyed the video, drop a like, subscribe for more. And of course, I will catch you all on the next one. Peace.